everyone, and welcome to a new Elektor TV video. In the previous video, I introduced the book KiCad 6 Like a Pro by Dr. Peter Dalmaris. We covered the content of the book. In this video, I would like to give you a short overview of KiCad 6. So, install KiCad 6 on your PCs and follow me in this short guided tour.
In this video, I will give a brief overview of KiCad 6 based on the book KiCad 6 Like a Pro. This overview will help you with the first hands-on activity of this course, in which you create your first PCB. Make sure you have installed KiCad on your computer so that you can follow along. If you haven't done so yet, you can go back to the chapter Get KiCad for your operating system, where information on installing KiCad on macOS, Windows, and Linux are provided.
So let's explore the KiCad Project Manager, also known as the main KiCad window.
When you first start KiCad, you will see this window. It gives you access to the various KiCad applications like the schematic and symbol editors and shows you the project files. It contains a toolbar on the left, the project files in the middle, and the application buttons on the right side. First, let's do a tour of the items in the top menu bar. Under the file menu, you can see the standard options for file and project management. You can open, close a project, create a new project, archive and archive a project, and import no KiCad projects. You will find some of these options as buttons in the right toolbar of the main KiCad window. The Tools menu gives you access to the individual apps in the KiCad software suite. The items in the menu replicate the applications buttons in the right pane of the KiCad main menu. The Preferences window contains several tabs with widgets that allow you to customize KiCad. Exactly what you see here depends on which applications are open. In our example, only the main KiCad project window is open. Here you can see the About KiCad window in Microsoft Windows. To report a bug, open the About KiCad window and click Report a Bug. Now let's take a closer look at the schematic editor. If you click on the Schematic Editor button, you will see this window. The Schematic Editor, or Eeschema, is the first KiCad application you will use when you start a new project. You can see here the symbols, green wires connecting pins, special symbols representing unconnected pins, and power nuts, and other elements like graphics and text labels. You can learn how to use and configure the Schematic Editor in another chapter of the KiCad Like a Pro book. Let's move now to the Symbol Editor. You can open this application from the KiCad Project Manager or the top toolbar of Eeschema. With the Symbol Editor, you can modify existing symbols to create new ones. You can think of the Symbol Editor as a simplified version of the Schematic Editor. In the Symbol Editor, you can work with a single symbol at a time. KiCad 6 comes with an extensive set of symbol and footprint libraries. There are also thousands of third-party symbols and footprints that you can import. You can also learn how to create new symbols from scratch with this book. Now let's take a look at the layout editor, also known as Pcbnew. Here you can see the finished PCB design of one of the demo projects. The layout editor allows you to select the layers and design elements you want to see. For example, you can enable or disable the visibility of layers, footprints, tracks, zones, and vias. The layout editor includes various sophisticated tools such as an interactive router and the 3D viewer. Everything you see here is configurable. The width of the traces, which layer they belong to, the shape, size, and configuration of the pads. You will learn all of this in this book. And from the layout editor, you can open your 3D viewer and you can see a 3D rendering of your PCB. Let's take a look at the footprint editor. You can open it from the KiCad project window or the Pcbnew top toolbar. With the footprint editor, you can create a footprint from scratch or modify an existing footprint. Let's move now to the calculator tools. The calculator tool contains multiple calculators, such as voltage regulators, RF attenuators, E-series, resistor color code, transmission lines, track width, board classes, and much more.
As you can see, this book will help you master PCB design, even if you don't have any prior knowledge of it. The if you'd like to master PCB design, you can get both of these books on the Elektor store. They are available individually and also as a bundle. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching and see you in another video.